Hey guys, so finally I'm here to talk about my issue with Netflix. And it's more than what the programs are. For me, it's more of the system as well. It's a bit of both, so I just want to quickly go into it just so you kind of know my issue. And I think the whole issue with the Netflix platform, a lot of people don't know, but Netflix is really algorithm-based. So basically, it keeps you watching Netflix productions. So you'll watch a TV show on Netflix original and it will recommend a Netflix original. But it goes deeper than that as well, with terms of producing as well, because it turns out that the algorithm works with programs as well in terms of creating the actual program, like producing and directing and everything. It really seeps its fingers into all aspects of a show on Netflix. Which means you'll see certain cliches and tropes in almost every single Netflix show. The same stuff happens in, I think, the past five Netflix shows I've tried. I've watched an episode or two and it's exactly the same. You'll see the same formula, the sex formula, the formula with social political messages, which really winds me up a little bit because I'm all for diversity representation in film, and it's the same, almost the same dialogue, you know, shouted at us, drilled into us over and over and over again. It just gets so monotonous and actually looks like pandering more than authentic creativity. Because I think when you're forcing people with messages and you're forcing people to keep watching certain shows or certain formulas, that's what I don't like, because it really is crushing the creative freedom of producers, directors, even writers, to not only, you know, they can't make the show that they want, they have to make the show that Netflix wants. And what Netflix wants is to keep you watching. And to keep you watching, they keep recommending the same old things over and over again. The next Netflix original, the next Netflix original. And it's the algorithm. It keeps you in, it tries to keep you in. Because, like, for instance, the 5-star rating system, they got rid of the star rating system because Netflix originals were doing so bad. So the actual stars on Netflix, the rating of the stars, isn't 5-star rating. It's what Netflix thinks that you want to watch out of 5 stars. So a 5-star rating would be like, Netflix recommends this compared to your other shows that you've watched. But if all your other shows are Netflix originals because they're forcing you to watch it, then it's going to be 5-star all the time. It's ridiculous. They got rid of that rating completely. They should have a thumbs up, thumbs down, or just a general peer rating system, which they completely took away. And that's awful, I think, because it's misleading. The next thing I want to talk about is the actual shows. I mean, I'm not one to say I haven't watched the shows, because I have. I started out watching Orange is the New Black, The Stranger Things, all the kind of beginning of the Netflix originals, but now it's becoming a platform where they're taking away the movies that you'd search and watch, and they're just making it Netflix original. And because they've made so much money, it's a billion-dollar industry, that they're going to keep producing their own stuff, and that means you're going to get the same messages, you're going to get the same plots, you're going to get the same rules, regulations, story devices that you need to put in to make a show in every single Netflix original. I mean, just go to any show, or just keep a note in your mind of certain tropes, like, you know, they have to have someone having sex in the first bloody 10 minutes or 20 minutes of every Netflix show, the weed thing, or the messages, the social messages and political messages that are fine to have in any production, because I think that needs to be stated, and we're moving into a place where we can get better representation and better represent diversity in film, which is absolutely important. But when Netflix does it in such a way that it feels forced, it feels like they're doing it just to please, you know, me or anyone else, or the LGBT community, then it looks like pandering more to me than authentic representation. And that really winds me up too. And it's so obvious and forced in every Netflix production that I've seen. Every single one, like, I'm not joking, every single Netflix original will have these tropes and cliches in them. And when same formula over and over again because they know it works, because they keep directing you to it, and then they keep rating it 5 stars. So it works for them because they're keeping you in the loop. You're always in the Netflix loop unless you're going outside of that. Now, I'm not saying it's all Netflix production, because there are some that are good. The movies often can be okay. You had the Buster Scruggs thing. I appreciated it, but I wasn't too big fan of it. You had the Iron Mother, I think it was called, sci-fi, which was decent. And you will get a few of these, but when it's the majority, that's when I have a problem with it, because I think we're at a stage where we need to evolve from everything we've done in the past. I mean, I always go on about it, but A24 seem to be doing that with horror genre, but we need that for other genres. I don't think we should have rules in film. I think that artists should have just completely creative control. Story writers should be able to write exactly what they want without having to think about rules and regulations. Now, of course, there are some rules and regulations that there should be, I guess, you know, just to make sure there is accurate representation and diversity. But in terms of story writing, it'd be nice to see just a complete free world, and, you know, to see what works and see, get new stuff out there, because everything is the same old rubbish. I mean, it was the same as cinema. I mean, all the horror movies with Blumhouse were coming out, and they're all the same, they're all boring, they're not well written, but they keep getting produced because they keep making millions, because they keep advertising it. And again, it's similar to Netflix, but that's a whole different video that I've done before. But yeah, that's really my issue with it all, is that it is, I guess, suppressing creativity and complete freedom of storytelling, and it often takes away from the storytelling, or from the stuff that makes a story a good story, and it seems to simplify it massively and keep in the algorithm, because like I said earlier, it's not just the algorithm keeps you watching, it actually keeps the production, and it actually has an outcome on how the program is made, because when it's rated 5 stars, that means Netflix and the algorithm sees those formulas work, and that they keep putting them in, so you know they'll keep liking it. It's a horrible, horrible thing that you're being forced to watch, and these programs are being forced into you, and these tropes are being forced into everything. And I've repeated myself a lot here, but it just angers me so much. And I know, okay, if you're sitting down for, you know, something stupid to watch or just casual, it's fine. And I'm not saying you shouldn't enjoy it. It's just my personal, real personal hatred for this platform. I mean, any multi-billion-dollar company always becomes corporate, always becomes algorithm, always becomes money-based, not creative-based. And this is what has happened with Netflix, and I think it's only just going to get worse. And you get other streaming competition that's going to come out and do the same. So I don't know what the future is, but I just wish we had more freedom, and I wish Netflix wasn't as obvious, or just wasn't as bloody bad with its rules and regulations, and even writing for the shows, because a lot of the time they're just so surface level, so standard, so simple, that, you know, when Game of Thrones did come around, it was game changing because it was written by a real writer who didn't have rules, who just made one of the best first 4 seasons ever, and people realized that because it was something they hadn't seen before, and Netflix would never take that chance. So yeah, that's my issue there. And just remember, it's not 5 star because people have rated it 5 star. It's Netflix rating it 5 star for you, and they've kept you in the loop, so they think that you're going to want to watch that. It's a relatability thing, and that's so wrong. So yeah, thanks for listening.